Welcome to Reptile Ridge. Right now, I'm committing a federal offense, a crime. And he's the reason why. Why is this a crime? Remember in the last episode, I talked about endangered species. Well, this creature is a federally protected species. It's a gopher tortoise. Since these animals are protected, it is illegal to touch, harm, harass, or collect wild gophers for pets. I've broken the law. However, I never intended on keeping this animal for a pet. This tortoise was found in a very dangerous situation. Walking down the middle of a highway, he was in immediate danger of being run over and killed. We had no choice but to rescue this magnificent, ancient reptile. Logging activity in the area may have forced him from his home. The species is now listed as endangered for that very reason. They're losing their habitat. Until we can find a suitable location for release, he's going to spend the rest of the night with us. Early the next day, we settle on a site to let him go, back on his journey. Gopher tortoises are on the decline. We have to protect them to make sure they survive. They've been on this planet for 60 million years. Now, humans threaten their existence by destroying habitat, killing them for food, and taking them for pets. They also have a very slow rate of reproduction, making it difficult for them to rebound after those losses. These tortoises don't reach sexual maturity until they are at least 10 years old. Gopher tortoises are also considered a keystone species. That means other animals rely on these tortoises for their survival. The tortoise's burrows are used by other species, some of them endangered as well, like the eastern indigo snake. Burrowing species of owls, foxes, raccoons, gopher frogs, rattlesnakes, toads, even race runners all depend on this tortoise for their survival. Since the tortoises are vegetarian, they contribute back to the environment by spreading seeds and promoting plant growth. And again, for the second time in just 2 weeks, we found another one. Both of these tortoises have been male. It's the height of the breeding season, and I'm sure they're searching for mates. This guy was trying to cross 6 lanes of traffic from that driveway to get to where he was going. Bad idea. Again, we break the law to save a life. Soon we find a safe spot to let him go. Listen to this. That's fun. The hissing and the banging of his shell is all an attempt to intimidate predators. Anyway, as soon as we set him free, he wasted no time. He's getting the heck out of Dodge. No, I did not speed this up. These guys can move pretty fast when they want to. He certainly made tracks getting away from here. Literally. Well, all I can say is happy trails, partner. I hope you find yourself a girlfriend soon. back to the serenity of my home, where the anoles roam. One of the females sticks close to her tree. Again, it's the height of the mating season for most of the reptiles of the ridge. The anoles are no exception. The only crimes being committed here are crimes of passion. The males continue to compete fiercely for mates. Right now, a territorial squabble ensues. Suddenly, one male takes off into the treetops, either to avoid his rival or the blue jays flying over. Then the other male comes into view. Who is this anole, masked by the leaves? Whoever he is, he's going to be a force to be reckoned with. Find out his identity next week in an all-new episode